So this is our graphical user interface. It's used to configure the product, but then it also displays and logs the data. So on the graphs, the top bluish green graph there is a torque measurement off of the test bar that we have. And the three red lines are X, Y, and Z axis acceleration. So as you look at the test bar here, if you look at the green line on the top, as I twist this bar, you can see that graph going up and down. And this is a 1-inch solid aluminum bar. So we're measuring the torque just for me twisting on it with my hands. And then the red lines, if I shake it this way, that's the Z axis it looks like on the bottom there. If I turn it 90 degrees and I do the same thing, I get the Y axis. And if I turn this on end, I get the Z axis. So if I have things like rotation on here, you can see that sort of sinusoidal wave on there. It's actually measuring plus or minus 1g. It's measuring gravity as this thing spins from the accelerometer. In addition, we have some low speed data channels over here on the left. It displays the high speed data, but it also has things like the processor temperature, which is a good surrogate for ambient temperature since our processor doesn't really generate any heat. And we can also put onboard pressure sensors for either gaseous or liquid pressure monitoring. And the external sensor, which is this strain gauge, can also be substituted with a K-type thermocouple for temperature measurement should it be needed. So the electronics are in the red case here in the mounting case, and there's a lithium polymer battery in the white case that's on there. And that would be the lithium polymer that we're using right there.
And this, you can get how many hours with this?
So it's data rate dependent. So if you run a higher data rate on the system, the battery life is shorter. Lower data rate, it's longer. With this size battery at maximum data rate, which is on this system is 4 kilohertz on each one of those channels, you'll get 80 hours of continuous testing and 6 to 9 months of standby. So this is transmitting to a base unit. So the base unit is receiving it on the antenna. We can pull digital data off of a USB connection, or we also have 4 user configurable analog outputs. So most of our customers actually use the 0 to 5 volt analog output to measure those things, and they tie it into their larger data acquisition systems. So as soon as we pull the power on this base unit, the remote goes into a sleep mode, and that's how you get the 6 to 9 months of standby time from that size rechargeable battery. On our oil and gas applications, we're using a non-rechargeable battery that is roughly the size of a D-sized alkaline. It's not an alkaline battery, but it's that size. And that gives us 2 years of battery life at the 100 hertz data rate that is being used for that product.
What is the distance of transmission that this can?
So on this particular system, we advertise 30 meters or about 100 feet line of sight. Our new system and the one that's used in oil and gas, we've successfully tested it up to 3 miles.
Wow.
And the only reason we stopped at 3 miles is that was the longest line of sight distance that we could find on a road to do the testing.